Welcome to Hibbert Health. Dr. Jose Luis Abreu is joining me today. Dr. Abreu, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so much for inviting me to your show. It's always a pleasure. I enjoy.
Thank you very much. Dr. Abreu is a scientist in Monterrey, Mexico. He has a lot of background in agriculture and a master's in phytochemistry. He also has a PhD in research and management. Dr. Abreu is president and research professor for Spenta University in Monterrey. Dr. Abreu, you just published a paper, Madagascar Protocol to Treat COVID-19. Can you explain why you have titled this Madagascar Protocol?
The Madagascar Protocol is based on the use of Artemisia annua, ivermectin, and other antimalarial drugs used in Madagascar and other African countries as a mass treatment for malaria. I would like to show you a table that I have with data to explain why I call it the Madagascar Protocol.
Thank you.
So this is about the Madagascar Protocol for COVID-19. This is the paper that I published on the Madagascar Protocol to treat COVID-19. It was published in this prestigious Diana journal on November. And I want to take the opportunity to thank you for your support as the editor of this paper. Now, back to your question about why it's called the Madagascar Protocol. I noticed when I compare the numbers related to death per million. In several countries, here the countries are USA, France, Mexico, Canada, and also I compare Madagascar with the world. Mainly I use this death per million factor. And as you can see, we have 24 deaths per million. When we look at the United States of America, we see a very big difference. It's very significant.
Can I point out something that you did here, which is quite important? You isolated the population over 25 years of age.
Yes, there are a few studies that they argue that Madagascar is doing better because they have a younger population than the rest of the countries. So I extracted the young population. So the difference is still significant. You will see that the difference between Madagascar and France, Mexico, Canada, and the whole world is very big. It's a big difference. So what is next? Well, a simple question. Why? Looking at this, I found reports on the impact of the use of anti-malarial drugs in Africa as a mass treatment. There have been studies that relate malaria with COVID-19. They say that they behave in a similar way. So, for example, it has been determined that ivermectin is a successful treatment for COVID-19. So what happened is that in several African countries, they have been using ivermectin to treat the population for parasites. In addition, they have been using Artemisia as a mass treatment for malaria. There have been studies expressing there is a connection between mass treatment of malaria and these low numbers in death per million in Madagascar. We notice that Madagascar death per million is the lowest. In order to understand the efficiency of Artemisia to treat COVID-19, we have to go to some basic knowledge. One of these is the relation of hydrogen peroxide and Artemisia. It's important to highlight that Artemisia has a chemical compound called artemisinin, and this artemisinin is a natural peroxide, is linked with a peroxide bridge. This applies to all of the derivatives of Artemisia. This includes Artemeter, Artesunate, and others. This Artemisia has been applied to treat malaria and cancer.
That's very interesting. If Artemisia has been used to treat malaria and cancer, and now it's being applied to COVID-19, there must be an association amongst these three diseases. Can you identify that connection for us, please?
It's a good question. There is a connection between malaria, cancer, and COVID-19. The connection is given by the interaction of hydrogen peroxide and iron. The connection between malaria and COVID-19 has been mentioned also by Dr. David Scheim and other scientists. I will be talking about this in another section. Okay, hydrogen peroxide moves across cell membranes just like water. It moves freely. Hydrogen peroxide can be used as an inter and intracellular signaling molecule. It has been found that at sites of inflammation, hydrogen peroxide is generated by activated phagocytes. What we can see here is that hydrogen peroxide is generated as a response of our body to some of the activities that happen in our body. Hydrogen peroxide participates to modulate the inflammatory process. This is another important factor because there is a process of inflammation that happens during the COVID-19 disease. Hydrogen peroxide helps in controlling cell proliferation and initiates also apoptosis and participates in modulating platelet aggregation, which is another factor during the process of COVID-19. Another important topic about hydrogen peroxide in our body, hydrogen peroxide participates in an important way during antiviral defense. It's been reported the role of reactive oxygen species in this antiviral defense. Hydrogen peroxide is part of this oxygen species, which I'm going to call ROS. The cell considers the appearance of virus as a signal for ROS production. It means that when the virus is present, the cell reacts, producing ROS. Okay? This motivates an increase in ROS during the replication of the virus inside the cell. The increase in ROS induces apoptosis in the infected cell before it becomes a source of massive infection for the neighbors. It means that this ROS not only kills the virus, but it also kills the infected cell. So this happened also with the help of hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide participates in the killing of the virus and in the killing of the infected cell. As we can see here, hydrogen peroxide is an important antiviral and antimicrobial agent. It also is a cytokine regulator. When this cytokine storm gets out of hand, so we're in trouble. It's important to establish the relation between ferritin and inflammation during COVID-19. Ferritin has been found in high levels in patients who have died of COVID-19. But there is a direct relation between high levels of ferritin and inflammation during COVID-19. So this has called the attention of the researchers. This offers an opportunity for treatment. This is important to understand. iron is required for viral replication. The virus needs high levels of iron. In this case, we're talking about ferritin.
I see this slide is mentioning silent hypoxia, ferritin, inflammation, multi-organ injury. All of these are very interesting topics that has been discussed by many researchers. Can you please elaborate on this for us?
With silent hypoxia, the patients don't have any symptoms, but the hypoxia is happening. When the patients and the doctors realize there is a problem, sometimes it's too late because the relevant symptoms are noticed at later stages. At the same time, we have been talking about the role of iron. We have high levels of iron, and in association with that, we have clumping and clotting of blood cells, which have been reported by Dr. Schein. All of these factors interacting lead to multi-organ failure. A few researchers have been discussing that the problem of COVID-19 is not only happening at the lungs, it happens in other organs. Dr. Heber, here we have to think about using Artemisia annua in order to target ferritin. Artemisia annua contains a peroxide bridge, so Artemisia annua is carrying hydrogen peroxide inside its structure. So we have that the cleavage of these endoperoxides produce free radicals, and these free radicals, they kill the virus. Artemisia annua reduces viral replication by controlling the iron. Impacting the iron, it stops viral replication. Also, we have been discussing the role of iron in inflammation. The hydrogen peroxide in Artemisia annua controls the iron that is motivating or inducing inflammation and infection. Another thing that produces this reaction is oxygen. When Artemisia reacts with iron, it produces oxygen. What happened here is that Artemisia annua inhibits hypoxia because it's providing oxygen. Several in vitro and in vivo models have proven that Artemisia annua is effective against multiple organ failure. How is that? Well, because Artemisia annua is modulating the inflammatory process, is controlling, is reducing the inflammation. This is the reaction that happens when you bring Artemisia annua into our system.
This is fascinating. I love this diagram. So let me go through this. The hydrogen peroxide interacts with the iron and turns Fe2 into Fe3, which is iron, and it creates a free radical. And the free radical is the poison that you're saying that destroys COVID, right? Correct?
Right.
Then you have, at the same time, hydrogen peroxide then converts Fe3 back to Fe2, and it produces oxygen. This is fabulous. Now, this is really interesting. However, it's not only the free radicals that kill the virus. Am I right? Please explain it.
Here we can see in this reaction that not only the free radicals attack the virus or inactivate the virus. Also, we have that by itself, hydrogen peroxide inactivates the virus. In addition, this reaction produces oxygen. This is a wonderful way to treat COVID-19. It offers several mechanisms.
Thank you so much for your explanation. Dr. Abreu, can you please explain how ivermectin plays a role in the Madagascar protocol?
Yes, the whole idea is to have combination of therapies, because there is not a magic bullet. We need to combine Artemisia with other drugs that have proven to be efficient for the treatment of COVID-19. And one of these is ivermectin. By coincidence, it's been used in Africa. They have been using Artemisia, they have been using ivermectin. Not only that, we need to improve our protocols. We cannot depend just in one solution. In this case, we could combine Artemisia with ivermectin, vitamin D3, zinc, vitamin C. These are good for fighting the virus.
So true. Thank you, Dr. Abreu. Artemisia sounds very promising for the treatment of COVID-19. And thank you so much for having this discussion with me and presenting all this information and bringing it forward. I really appreciate it.